Don't adjust your sets. It is that time. It is the spring break edition of Sports Frenzy.
Oh, yes, the spring break edition of Sports Frenzy. Welcome, Frenzy Head Nation. We are live on MTV Live. That's what it is. There you go.
We are?
From the beaches of Florida.
Yes.
MTV Live Spring Break, baby. No, not really, but...
I was going to say our set, we must have picked up my whole...
I don't even think MTV does Spring Break anymore.
No, they don't.
It hates me quite a bit.
No, they don't. Good try,
but
though.
It used to be pretty cool.
Yeah, it did.
And it would have been cool to have our show back in the day like that.
Yeah, but we would have had to pick up this whole house and move it, and I don't think that's happening anytime soon.
Yeah, probably would have. To keep it PG, we would have had to censor a lot of stuff, too.
Yeah, this is true, but...
But this is the whole blog edition of Sports Frenzy anyway, so...
It is.
There you go.
It
everybody's
is.
On spring break. Well, everybody but Rose.
I know. I still gotta work. As you can see by the scrubs, woo!
Rose hasn't done a spring break since, what year? It's been a long time.
I'll date myself. I was still working for the ISD, I think, at the time.
Yeah, that's the last time you had a spring break?
I believe it was, yep.
Yep. Your line of work, you don't get spring breaks anymore.
No, there's no off time.
No, there's not.
No, but let's do it.
People in need don't take time off like students do.
Nope, but
we got
a lot to cover.
To though, so.
Yeah, we got a lot to cover. Let's get into it.
Let's do it.
NHL hockey.
I have no idea where this is going this week. This is all
I
Rose.
I can totally mess with him if I want to, but I won't.
He could really throw me off.
NHL hockey. 18-13-5 Detroit Red Wings versus the 12-20-4 Colorado Avalanche.
I'll take the Wings.
I'll take the Wings also.
This is going to put me through a lot of thinking, too, because I'll be sitting here trying to process all these numbers he's throwing out at me.
You got to do it quick here. Got to do it quick. Focus, Tim.
Yeah.
Focus.
Yeah, right.
18-15-3 New York Rangers versus the 28-10 Pittsburgh Penguins.
Go with the Penguins.
I have the Penguins also. 16-17-3 Dallas Stars versus the 25-7-5 Anaheim Ducks.
Anaheim.
Is it still Anaheim?
Still Anaheim?
I believe it is still Anaheim.
I'm sure. I think it is.
Who cares? NCAA basketball tournament final four games.
Oh, yeah.
30-8 ninth seed Wichita State versus 33-5 ranked one Louisville.
I'll go with Louisville.
I have Louisville also. Hang on, before I even announce it, I'm gonna already know where our answers are going.
Go blue!
30-9
Go blue.
Fourth seed Syracuse versus 30-7 fourth seed Michigan, and that is I got them right there. A 3-point bonus game.
We got 3-point bonus games, and there's nobody even playing but us.
It doesn't matter. Michigan. Yeah, well, that is true.
We have certain rules we have to follow. There's things we just can't step away from.
I don't know why I made that a 3-point bonus game, because I should have foreseen that you and I would have went with Michigan on that one.
Yeah, exactly.
That one didn't... I guess I wasn't thinking about that one too closely.
Oh, well. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't.
It's spring break. It's all in good fun.
This is true. Major League Baseball. I believe this is opening day for the Tigers here. 0-2 New York Yankees versus the 1-2 Detroit Tigers.
Go Tigers. They didn't look pretty today, but go Tigers.
Go Tigers. 1-2.
Awful game today.
Yeah. 1-2 St. Louis Cardinals versus the 2-1 San Francisco Giants.
San Francisco Giants for me.
Giants also for me. 1-1. I don't know where they are anymore. Angels. Are they in San Francisco or Anaheim or LA or... I can't keep track of it. Versus
I think it's LA.
I think you're right. Okay. I think you're right. Versus the 2-1 Rangers.
Rangers.
I got the Angels. Oh no, I'm really? Not. Actually, I'm gonna go with the Rangers. Actually, scratch that.
Which is it?
I'm going with the Rangers.
You can't pick both.
I want to. That way, I'm a winner either way. Minor league baseball.
Minor league baseball.
That's
wow.
Right. No, there are. This is, I believe, today they had their opening day, but I don't have the records from today. But it don't matter because it'd be only one game. So the 0-0 Toledo Mud Hens versus the 0-0 Louisville Bats.
Going with the Mud Hens, looking for big things out of them this year. And yes, this is their opening game tonight.
Mud Hens.
Not at their place, but it's opening for yep. Miners.
Yep. I have Mud Hens too. 0-0.
Mud Hens open up at home next week, I believe.
Ooh. The 0-0 Dayton Dragons versus the 0-0 West Michigan Whitecaps. That's in, I believe they're in Grand Rapids, by the way. So it's like the Grand Rapids Whitecaps.
Okay, I'll go with them.
I have them also. Oh, I need you, Tim.
You do?
Arena!
Football!
Football, 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 football. Arena football!
I don't believe it. We still have arena football.
We do. The 0-2 Chicago Rush versus the 0-1 San Antonio Talons.
Oh and two and oh and one. Wow, this is a. I guess I'll go with the Rush.
I have the Rush also.
Just because the name sounds a little cooler.
I know we love that. Now, as I thought last year, the Rush were a really good football team.
They might have been.
Apparently, this year they're not though.
You could look back at your old book and see.
It is behind
me,
actually.
Right here in the set.
It is. It's right behind me. Right in between us. But I don't feel like flipping through that many pages. 2-1 Jacksonville Shark versus the 0-2 Cleveland Gladiators.
Sharks.
Shark for me also. NBA action. 48-27 Indianapolis Pacers versus the 28-47 Washington Wizards.
Go with Pacers.
Pacers,
go Pacers.
Also for moi. 18-57 Charlotte Bobcats versus the 43-31 Brooklyn Nets.
I got the Nets.
I have the Nets also. 30-44 Philadelphia 76ers versus the 58-16 Miami Heat.
Pass.
Ooh. Well, I'm going for the point, so I got the Heat. 25-51 stinky Detroit Pistons versus the 28-46 Minnesota Timberwolves.
Alright, so, you know, here's the thing that irritates me about this. The Pistons suck, okay? They suck. They're horrible. But they've somehow managed to beat the Celtics like 3 times this year already. 3 times! Now, I know the Celtics aren't great this year, but they shouldn't be losing to the stinky Pistons. Alright, that's my rant on that. What was the Bobcats record again?
28-46.
28-46.
Yeah.
And the Pistons?
25-51.
You know, I'm going Bobcats because the last time the Pistons had a really close record team like that, they played.
Timberwolves, you mean?
Yeah, they lost to them. So, I'm going to say they're going to lose to the Bobcats.
The Timberwolves, you mean?
Oh, it's just.
The Minnesota yeah. Timberwolves.
Okay.
You got them, huh?
Yeah, I got them.
I'm going with the Roses upset special. I got the Pistons.
That wouldn't be an upset special.
It would be an upset for them to win. So I have the Pistons winning it.
They beat the Celtics the other night. There's no way they're going to win again.
I know. I don't know. 42-34 Atlanta Hawks versus the 56-19 San Antonio Spurs.
San Antonio.
San Antonio for me also. 42-33 Houston Rockets. I had to think where they were from. Sorry. Versus the 51-24 Denver Nuggets.
Nuggets
also for me. 28-47 Toronto Raptors versus the 36-38 Bucks. Milwaukee Bucks.
I guess.
I have the Bucks also. No, hang on, I gotta flip back. Oh shoot, I don't have that anymore, do I? No, I don't. Oh, roll it! I gotta roll the beautiful bean footage.
Oh!
We got NASCAR! Roll it! Love it.
Love it.
Now, last week we didn't have NASCAR, Tim.
No, we didn't.
Do you remember who you went with the week before?
I had the winner, Bush.
So you had Kyle. So it's my turn for Kyle then. So I got Kyle, you got Kurt this week. Oh, and it is that time of the year. It is Wrestle! Mania!
Big one.
It is.
WrestleMania what?
Is it 29?
Is it? That's what I asked you.
I think it's 29. Pretty sure it's 29.
Okay. I'll take your word for it.
It's either 28 or 29.
So who's Hulk Hogan facing this year? Oh, that's right. He's not in WWE anyway.
He's not in WWE. We do have some olders, though. Oldies in here. Well, this might be a record for us for wrestling.
Oh, boy.
We have 6 matches to pick from this year. Because actually, it looks like a decent WrestleMania.
It might be, actually, for once.
And this, actually, I'm excited for this. This host gets to watch WrestleMania this year, actually. First time ever in 28, 29 years that I've actually gotten
to
watch.
You're going to be there live?
No, I'm not going to be there live. I'm just watching on pay-per-view TV.
Oh, okay.
So, which I'm excited for just for that reason. So.
Right.
But, first off, the WWE Championship match. The Rock! The Great One, the People's Champion, versus, you can't see me, John Cena. Who do you got, Tim?
The Rock is going to win this one, and we are going to see the heel turn of John Cena, I believe.
Ooh. I have John Cena this year, and I am with you. I think Cena is going to turn bad at WrestleMania. So I think he's going to cheat or somehow do some way to win the WWE Championship, but he'll be turning heel.
I just don't see them, this is just my take on it, that new, you know, Rock has made a new title. I can't see them just doing away with that already because...
last week, Cena actually said that he is going to hold on. He's not going to bring back the spinner belt if he wins it. He wants to hold on to the new title belt as a reminder to The Rock that Cena beat The Rock. So Cena has already said he's not bringing back the spinner title.
Oh, interesting. you might be onto something there.
He wants to hold on to it, so that's why I'm going with Cena.
Either way, if he wins it, he's going to cheat. It's not going to be legit.
It's
so.
Not, nope.
Turning heel.
Yep.
By his attitude, he's turning heel.
I agree.
People are actually excited about that.
Yeah. It's time for Cena to do something different. Everybody's tired of the Fruity Pebbles shirts, so. But, on to the other pay-per-view. The World Heavyweight Championship match. Jack Swagger, We the People, versus... Oh, crap, hang on. I'm going to lose my voice here. Alberto Del Rio!
Swagger for the win.
Oh, wow. I gotta go with Alberto Del Rio.
They're playing him up too much for him not to win.
I don't know. The way Alberto Del Rio's been...
He's gonna go in there and take the title, one way or another.
He just came back. I don't know. I don't think they're gonna give him the title that quick. But, on to the show. The next match, Orton, Big Show, Sheamus, versus The Shield.
Shield.
I have Orton, Show, and Sheamus. Which
they're
I think
gonna find a way for them not to get along. If something's gonna happen, Shield's gonna win.
I find this very funny. We went pretty much the whole way down this whole thing. Yeah, the same. We come to wrestling and we're going opposites on everything. this is our last. Basically, it comes down to 1, 2, 3. Oh, I forgot to mention the Rock and Cena match. I'm making that our other 3-point bonus game.
Nice.
Oh, the Undertaker streak. Versus CM Punk. Best in the world!
Man, this is a tough one.
Yep.
I could see this going either way. This is a tough... For the record, I'm going to say Taker Street's going to stand. But it's going to take some help from Kane, I do believe.
I have Taker, too. I can't believe they go 20 years in a row. Or not in a row, but 20 years streak, and then all of a sudden CM Punk comes along and breaks the record. I just don't see it. So
I CM Punk doesn't need any publicity builders. So
yep.
You know, I mean, he's done everything he needs to do. So yeah, I don't see it happening.
I have Taker also.
Big event. He's done a great job of pulling off the bad guy role, especially for this situation.
Yep.
He's just been a total prick for the whole Undertaker thing. Perfect, you know, perfect scenario for them. I mean, it worked out well. I mean, it's to say that, you know, Paul Bearer's death was a sad thing, you know, that was a sad thing, but I mean, CM Punk has taken that and just ran with it.
Yep.
So, I mean, that... probably could not have worked out better for this storyline.
Yeah. I gotta say, you know, I don't really like... I like Punk better as a good guy, but I actually like him a little bit better, actually, as a bad guy. He makes an awesome bad guy, I have to say.
And, you know, they're pushing the boundaries a little bit with the whole PG-rated, wrestling for, kids right now. I mean, that whole scene last week was a bit eerie.
Yep.
And, Heyman coming dressed up like a pallbearer, that was pretty eerie too, actually. They did a pretty darn good job of making him look like him.
Yeah.
But I still think Taker's going to get the win. I just think he's going to have help from Kane, I think.
He'll have help from someone, I think, so.
It's going to be, I have a feeling Kane's going to be down there at some point.
Yep. But, well, next match. Ryback versus Mark Henry. I have Ryback.
I think I'm going to go with Ryback, too.
And
Mark Henry really hasn't been doing too much as of late.
Yep.
He just came back not that long ago.
Yep.
And they're trying to promote Ryback pretty big right now. So, yeah, I think Ryback's going to win that one.
And last but not least, no holds bar, Triple H, The Game, versus Brock Lesnar. Triple H's wrestling career is on the line. If Triple H loses, he's done wrestling. Who do you?
It actually, you know, they said it sounds like it's his whole career that's supposed to be on the line. So, from what Heyman was saying last week, that he would lose his job completely, which we all know that ain't gonna happen.
Yeah.
I got Triple H winning this match with some help from all the DX brothers.
I also have Triple H going all the way, baby. All the way.
Shawn Michaels in his corner, and I think you're gonna end up seeing Road Dogg and Billy Gunn there too.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Not Xbox.
Not Xbox, no. He's
and not China either.
No. He's recovering from an injury. We'll just we'll leave it at that.
Here's another scenario I was thinking about WrestleMania. So, if either way, I think the heavyweight title is going to exchange hands this way, you know. I got a feeling about this. I have a feeling even if Alberto Del Rio does pull off the win, he's going to be so beat up from that, and what's his name there is going to
fly in
and cash in his money in the
Dolph
bank.
Dolph Ziggler.
Yep,
I'm trying to think if Dolph Ziggler even has a match.
I don't think he does.
Let me look it up here real quick here. And we shall.
Because they've been battling. No, they haven't. I was just saying, haven't they been battling with Team Hell No, but they haven't been.
Yeah, they have been. Yep.
And they're not. They don't have a match.
That's what I'm looking up real quick. Seeing if that is a match. Alright, go down. Go down. There it goes. Whoa. Oh, they do. Yep. They're the WWE Tag Team Champions. Team Hell No versus Dolph Ziggler and Big E Langston.
Oh, really? Oh,
yep.
Okay.
That is there. So they do have a match at WrestleMania.
Oh, alright. Well, there you go.
So, and I know the pre-game match is, or the pre-show, which is on YouTube and I think Facebook and something else. It's being really pushed, the pre-show match. It's Wade Barrett versus The Miz for the Intercontinental Championship. So, but
you know, just because we can do whatever we want to do.
Uh-oh.
Because it's our show, and you know, nobody's really paying attention this week anyway. We're adding a match.
What?
Let's throw the Jericho match in there too.
What?
That's right. Who you got? Van Dong whatever or Chris Jericho?
You said it wrong there. You would.
I know.
Kick
I said it on purpose.
Him off.
Because I don't care about that dude.
His name is. There's Chris Jericho, Y2J, Chris Jericho, versus Fandango.
I've got Jericho.
I have Jericho, too. I will be shocked if Fandango wins.
And that's is WrestleMania 29?
It is, yes. I'm looking at that right now.
That's a 29-point bonus game, then.
On that match?
On that match.
Oh, man. Oh, I hate to break it to you. I already threw my notebook across the room.
That's all right.
I got it.
Remember this.
I got it. I got it. Hang on. I got it now. I got it. And, but I have no room to write it.
we'll remember.
I have no room to write it. Look, it's all the whole thing. Well, either way, we both have Y2J.
Yeah, so it really don't matter.
Yeah, I'll just do it that way and then maybe write Fandango, scribble it up there. There you go, it's up there. See, nobody even cares about that guy. So, well, we have some sad news for you Lion fans today.
Sadder than normal Lion news.
Yeah. The longtime kicker, Jason Hansen, announces his retirement.
This really is bad news, guys. I mean, this guy has been the most reliable source to the Lions for many, many, many years. As far as I'm concerned, he was the franchise player for the team.
Yep.
He's been through 5, 6 coaches. He's been with the team since the Wayne Font days.
Yep.
That's how long he's been with this team. So this is a sad day to see him go. That man won many, well, not many, but he won a lot of games for us from his field goal kicks. And he was a, you know, and I am swearing a little bit, a hell of a kicker. One of the best kickers ever out there. And so he's going to be sadly missed.
Little facts for everybody there. Jason Hansen spent 21 seasons with the Lions, more than 6 times the length of the average NFL career. Let's see, Hansen made a record 52 field goals from at least 50 yards.
I was just going to ask you that, what his longest recorded field goal was.
He's third on the career scoring list at 21. Or 2,150 points and third in field goals with 495. Hansen is the only player with 2,000 points from one franchise.
He's a true, and his jersey should be getting retired as far as I'm concerned.
Hansen joined the Lions in 1992, the year after they reached the NFC Championship game. He played in 6 postseason games, all losses, and endured the team's 0-16 performance of 2008. I look forward to my press conference next Tuesday when I publicly thank so many people who have played such a big part in my career, Hansen said. You all helped me along this journey, and I am forever grateful.
True gentleman, and a true loss for the Lions.
Yes, that is a big loss.
This is going to hurt bad. I mean,
yep.
There's no two ways of saying it. It's going to hurt bad.
Yep. And
I know he struggled a little bit last year, but he still was better than most your kickers out there.
Well, I was reading also that he had a heel spur. And I guess he was keeping it real hush-hush. So I think that's one reason why you saw that happen. Why he didn't have such a great year last year, because he had that heel spur. So.
Yeah.
And more sad news for the state of Michigan.
Oh, boy.
The Tigers re-sign Jose Valverde to a minor league deal. And as you may recall, Jose Valverde was Detroit Tigers' closer last year. And I believe he almost cost them the a couple.
He came real close to blowing it.
Yeah, he almost cost them a couple playoff games there last year. That's when they took him totally out of the lineup. And I don't think this is a good signing. I don't think that this was...
I was listening today when I was watching the Tigers game. They were talking to the GM, and, you know, it strictly is a minor league deal. They're not looking at bringing him back up anytime soon to the Tigers organization. He's strictly signed to the Mud Hens at the moment. And they said, you know, they saw some things that, you know, made them kind of look at him, but he pretty much made it clear that it was a minor league deal. So it's strictly for the Mud Hens right now. They have no intentions. At this point, they have no intentions of bringing him up to Tigers. So I don't know what that means, but
here's after converting all 49 of his save opportunities with a ERA of 2.24 in 2011, Valverde was 35 for 40 with a 3.78 ERA last year. His velocity was down, and he gave up a pair of two-run homers to the Yankees in the ninth inning of the AL Championship Series opener. Given a 10-day break and stripped of the closer role, Valverde was hit hard again in his World Series appearance, in his only World Series appearance. In four postseason games, he allowed 11 hits, 9 runs, and 2 homers while recording only 8 outs.
Was that the final, I forget, final World Series game?
I can't remember which
World Series. Where he had, like,
it was,
they brought him in to close out one guy. They had to get, one out. They had to get one out, and he almost blew that.
Yeah, well, they lost all games in the World Series last year, but yeah, it was not pretty last year, so yeah, I don't know if that's really a great idea, but I don't know. What can you do?
Yep, not our decision. See what happens down in the minors, so
that's
yeah.
Right. Good luck, Mud Hens, with them.
Yep, exactly.
So, but, well, you got anything for us, Tim?
I got nothing. It's spring break.
That's okay. That's cool. So.
Well, anything I've got, I've probably posted to the blog already, so.
Hey, there you go. This
in
is going
one form or another, either on Facebook or Twitter.
Yep,
so.
Well, this is going on the blog either way, so. But
that's right.
Well, that's all I got, so.
Everybody have a great spring break. Enjoy WrestleMania if you're getting it, because it's probably going to be one of the better ones.
Yep.
Have a great weekend, everybody.
Yeah. I think we'll have a recap show Monday for everybody out there on the blog, so. Because Sunday is going
to, WrestleMania will be late.
Yep.
And I'll be getting updates from Rose.
Yep.
But she's going to be enjoying it from a friend's house.
Well, I'd invite you over too, but it's in Holland, so.
That's right. The jet's not working. The transporter's not put together.
Yep.
It's just not possible.
It's not. It's not.
And I can't afford to rent it, so.
So.
Or neither could Rose if he wasn't going to a friend's house, so.
I'll text you.
Sounds good to me, man. All right. I am the coach.
And I'm Rose.
And if you're not down with that,
we got two words for you. Break it down! You could tell me.